In 1909, Norwegian explorer Roald Amundsen was preparing an expedition to reach the North Pole. He had spent several years planning, raised fundings, and borrowed the ship from renowned explorer Fridtjof Nansen. Everything was ready. Then news arrived that American explorers claimed to have reached the North Pole. Amundsen's plans were ruined. There was no more glory in reaching the North Pole. Public interest decreased, and he was facing bankruptcy. He had to achieve something great within polar exploration, so in all secrecy he changed his goal of destination to the last place where no man had been. The last great problem, as Amundsen said. In August of 1910, he set off from Norway with Fram and his crew. When they reached their last port of call in Madeira, Amundsen announced his new plans. On 14th of January 1911, Fram arrived in the Bay of Wales. The next 9 months was spent laying out supply depots, training their 110 Greenland sledge dogs and learning about the territory, all while working in weather as cold as minus 60 degrees Celsius. The crew was a party of 19, amongst them Roald Amundsen, of course, Helmer Hansen, who had been on previous expeditions with Amundsen, Sverre Hassel, expert on dogs, Oscar Wisting, naval officer, and Olaf Bjaaland, Norwegian ski champion. On the 20th of October, the five of them left Framheim with 4 sleds and 52 dogs into the unknown. The coldest place on earth, a desert of ice. The only thing they knew was that no man had been there before. In his book, The South Pole, Amundsen describes the almost 2-month-long journey south as tough, but without major problems. They encountered obstacles such as fog and blizzards, major ice cracks, steep glaciers, and terrains up to 3,000 meters, all in freezing weather. They covered on average 25 kilometers a day, and on the 14th of December, they finally reached the South Pole. It was a great victory for Amundsen and Norway, although the joy of this accomplishment was overshadowed by the death of Robert Falcon Scott with the Terra Nova expedition, who arrived to the South Pole 5 weeks later and died on their way back. For the rest of his life, Amundsen continued exploring the polar continents until he disappeared in the Arctic while on a rescue mission in 1928.